Problem number 13. Evaluate integral 0 to infinity x power 8 into 1 minus x to the power of 6 whole divided by 1 plus x whole to the power of 24 dx. Take the given integral x power 8 into 1 minus x to the power of 6 by 1 plus x whole to the power of 24 dx. Therefore, this can be written as integral 0 to infinity x to the power of 8 by 1 plus x whole to the power of 24, multiplying and separating the integration integral 0 to infinity x to the power of 8 into x to the power of 16, x to the power of 8 into x to the power of 6, x to the power of 14 by 1 plus x whole to the power of 24 dx. Therefore, this can be written as integral 0 to infinity x to the power of 8 can be written as 9 minus 1 by 1 plus x whole to the power of 24 can be written as now 9 plus 15. So 15 plus 9 minus integral 0 to infinity x to the power of 14 can be written as 15 minus 1 by 1 plus x whole to the power of 24 can be written as 15 plus 9 into dx. Therefore, this is equal to beta m comma n. M is 15 here, n is 9 here, minus beta here, m is 9 and n is 15, 9 comma 15. Since beta m comma n is equal to integral 0 to infinity y to the power of n minus 1 by 1 plus y whole to the power of m plus n into dy. This is the formula. Therefore, here in the first integration, n is equal to 9, m is equal to 15. So 15 comma 9. Here n is 15, m is 9. So m comma n, 9 comma 15. Therefore, now again by the property of symmetric of the beta function, this can be written as beta 15 comma 9 minus beta 15 comma 9. Since beta m comma n is equal to beta n comma m. So beta m comma n is equal to beta n comma m. This is we already proved as a symmetric property of a beta function. Therefore, beta 15 comma 9 minus beta 15 comma 9, this is equal to 0. So therefore, this value is equal to 0. This is our integration value. Therefore, integral 0 to infinity x to the power of 8 into 1 minus x to the power of 6 by 1 plus x whole to the power of 24 dx equal to 0. This is our required value of the integration. Now, problem number 14. Evaluate integral 0 to infinity x to the power of 4, 1 plus x to the power of 5 by 1 plus x whole to the power of 15 into dx. As above, you can evaluate this integral. Same procedure. So, same way. The answer is 2 into beta 10 comma 5. 2 times beta, since there is a plus. So, we get the addition. In the earlier problem, there is a minus. So, we got 0. Now, here 2 times beta 10 comma 5. Beta of 10 comma 5. That is the answer for problem number 14. Next, another one. Given integral 0 to infinity x to the power of n minus 1 by 1 plus x whole to the power 1 plus x dx is equal to pi by sine n pi. Show that gamma n into gamma 1 minus n equal to pi by sine n pi, and hence evaluate integral 0 to infinity dy by 1 plus y to the power of 4. Now, solution. Given that integral 0 to infinity x to the power of n minus 1 by 1 plus x dx is equal to pi by sin n pi. Therefore, now we know that beta m comma n is equal to gamma m into gamma n by gamma m plus n is equal to beta m comma n, and also say this is equation number 1. Therefore, this is equal to integral 0 to infinity x to the power of n minus 1 by 1 plus x whole to the power of m plus n dx. Since beta m comma n is equal to x to the power of n minus 1 by 1 plus x whole to the power of m plus n, by the transformations of beta function, there is a, we proved in terms of y, but here for our convenience we are writing x. So therefore, in the left hand side, gamma m gamma n by gamma m plus n, in this what m plus n is equal to 1, and also this implies m is equal to 1 minus n. Therefore, this is equal to left hand side gamma m is equal to 1 minus n. So therefore, 1 minus n into gamma n by gamma m plus n, we assumed that 1, is equal to beta m comma n value integral 0 to infinity x to the power of n minus 1 by 1 plus x whole to the power of 1 into dx. To use equation 1, we assumed that m plus n is equal to 1. So Therefore, by equation number 1, this value is equal to pi by sine n pi from equation number 1. Therefore, gamma n into gamma 1 minus n is equal to pi by sine n pi, since from equation number 1. Since from equation 1 and also gamma 1 is equal to 1. We used these two facts here from equation 1. X to the power of n minus 1 by 1 plus x dx is equal to pi by sine n pi. So therefore we substituted this value here. So therefore gamma n into gamma 1 minus n is equal to pi by sine n pi. This is our required answer for the gamma n into gamma 1 minus n. And also you ask to evaluate integral 0 to infinity dy by 1 plus y whole to the power of y to the power of 4. Take the given integration, integral 0 to infinity dy by 1 plus y power 4. Therefore, integration by substitution, here put y to the power of 4 is equal to t to get 1 plus t. So therefore, differentiating on both sides, we get 4 into y cube into dy is equal to dt. Therefore, by cross multiplication, dt by 4 into y cube, but y is equal to, since y to the power of 4 is equal to t, y is equal to t to the power of 1 by 4. Therefore, substitute the value of y here. So therefore, dy is equal to 1 by 4 into y, that is t to the power of 1 by 4 whole cube into dt. Therefore, that is 1 by 4 into t to the power of 3 by 4 into dt. This is dy. Therefore, how the limits will become changes if you change y in terms of t. The lower limit of y is 0. The lower limit of y is 0 and upper limit is infinity. When y equal to 0, t equal to y to the power of 4 equal to 0. When y tends to infinity, t equal to y to the power of 4, this also tends to infinity. Substituting these values in the given integration, substituting these values in the above integral, that is 0 to infinity 1 by 1 plus y power 4 dy is equal to, so lower limit 0 becomes 0, infinity upper limit becomes infinity. So 0 to infinity and 1 by 1 plus y power 4, we assumed that equal to t. Dy is equal to dt by 4 into y to the power of 3, that is 1 by 4 into t to the power of 3 by 4 dt. 1 plus t into dy is equal to dt by 4 into t to the power of 3 by 4 equal to integral 0 to infinity 1 by 4 into t to the power of 3 by 4 t to the power of minus 3 by 4 by 1 plus t into dt. This can be written as 1 by 4 times integral 0 to infinity t to the power of this can be written as minus 3 by 4 can be written as 1 minus 1 by 4 minus 1 by 1 plus t dt. Therefore, 1 by 4 minus 1 is equal to 1 minus 4, that is a minus 3 by 4. Therefore, this is 1 by 4 into from equation number 1 t to the power of n minus 1 by 1 plus t dt. In the integration equation number 1, he has given x to the power of n minus 1 by 1 plus x is equal to pi by sin n pi. Therefore, this is equal to, by using same formula, pi by sin n pi. Here, n is 1 by 4. So, pi by 4. Since using equation number 1. From equation number 1. In the equation number 1, see. Integral 0 to infinity x to the power of n minus 1 by 1 plus x is equal to pi by sin n pi. Here, instead of n 1 by 4, therefore pi by sin n pi, that is pi by 4. Therefore, this is equal to 1 by 4 into pi by sin pi by 4, that is sin 45 degrees, 1 by root 2, that is equal to square root of 2 by 4 can be written as 2 into root 2 into root 2 into pi. So therefore, root pi root 2 square root of 2 gets cancelled. Therefore, this value is equal to pi by 2 root 2. So therefore, integral 0 to infinity 1 plus y power 4 dy is equal to pi by 2 root 2. This is our required value of the integration. Problem number 16. So that two to the power of n into gamma n plus 1 by 2 equal to 1 into 3 into 5 into and so on 2n minus 1 into square root of pi. Solution. We know that recurrence relation or reduction formula of gamma n plus 1 n into gamma n, say this is equation number 1. Therefore, now take the left hand side of given problem. Gamma n plus 1 by 2 is equal to, this can be written as gamma n plus 1 by 2 minus 1 and plus 1, adding and subtracting 1. To use the above formula, we are arranging, adding and subtracting 1. So gamma n plus, this is equal to minus 1 by 2, plus 1 by 2, minus 1 is 1 by 2, plus 1. Therefore, by using the equation number 1, this is of the form gamma n plus 1, n into gamma n. So here n is n minus half. In the place of n, there is n minus half. So this can also be simplifying gamma LCM, 2n minus 1, 2n minus 1 by 2 into plus 1. So therefore, gamma 2n minus 1 by 2 plus half. Therefore, this can be written as by using the formula number 1, gamma n plus 1 is equal to n into gamma n. So, before applying here, now I am applying after taking the LCM. So, therefore, that is better. So, therefore, n into gamma n in the place of n, there is a 2n minus 1 by 2. So, 2n minus 1 by 2 into gamma 2n minus 1 by 2. Again, this can be written as 2n minus 1 by 2 into gamma 2n minus 1 by 2 minus 1 plus 1. Same operation again we are performing, adding and subtracting 1 to apply the formula number 1. Here from 1 we are adding and subtracting 2n minus 1 by 2 into gamma 2n minus 1 minus 2, that is minus 3 by 2 plus 1. Therefore, again by using equation 1, gamma n plus 1 is equal to n into gamma n. So 2n minus 1 by 2 into 2n minus 3 by 2 into gamma 2n minus 3 by 2. In the place of n, here 2n minus 3 by 2. Therefore, similarly, we get 2n minus 1 by 2 into 2n minus 3 by 2 into 2n minus 5 by 2 into gamma 2n minus 5 by 2. Similarly, proceeding as above, we get 2n minus 1 by 2 into 2n minus 5 by 2 into gamma 2n minus 5 by 2 similarly proceeding as above, this can also be written as 2n minus 1 by 2, 2n minus 3 by 2. If you can continue this product up to n terms, 2n minus 5 by 2 and so on, 3 by 2 into 1 by 2 into gamma 1 by 2. Since last factor into gamma of the factor. So therefore here 1 by 2 into gamma 1 by 2. So these are the product of odd numbers. Product of odd 2n minus 1, 2n minus 3, 2n minus 5, odd numbers. So and so on. Continuing this process, we get 3, 1, by 2 into, by 2 is common in all the factors. Therefore, 1 by 2 into gamma 1 by 2. These are all the product of odd numbers. We observe that 2n minus 1 by 2, 2n minus 3 by 2, 2n minus 5 by 2 and so on. Gamma 2n minus last factor into gamma of last factor. So, therefore, we continue like this up to n terms. We get proceeding as above up to n terms, we get 1 by 2 into gamma n 1 by 2. So proceeding as above up to n terms, we get, therefore this is equal to. So here how can you say that these are n terms? For example, see, this is in the arithmetic progression 1, 3, 5, 2n minus 1, 2n minus 3 and so on. Tn is equal to nth term. This is in the arithmetic progression. Tn is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. Here, beginning value 1, plus n minus 1 into d difference between any two values. So that is a 2 since arithmetic progression. Therefore, 1 plus 2n minus 2. Therefore, this is equal to 2n plus 1 minus 2. That is minus 1. So in the arithmetic progression, nth term is 2n minus 1. See here, 2n minus 1. Therefore, we have n terms here. We have n terms. Therefore, this can be written as 1 by 2 to the power of n, 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 and so on, n terms. Therefore, 2n minus 1 into 2n minus 3 into 2n minus 5 and so on, 3, 1 into gamma half, that is equal to square root of pi. Therefore, in the left hand side, we have gamma n plus half. Gamma n plus half. Therefore, by cross multiplication, this value is equal to 2 power n into gamma n plus 1 by 2. That is equal to, in the reverse order, if you can write 1, 3, 5 and so on, 2n minus 5, 2n minus 3 into 2n minus 1 into square root of pi. This is our required value. In the given problem, you ask to prove that left hand side is equal to right hand side.